Hello there everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be talking about pathological myopia, which is pathological short-sightedness. If you want to learn more about this, then please stay tuned. Pathological myopia only affects a small number of short-sighted patients worldwide. The significance of pathological myopia is the fact that it can be associated with lots of other problems that the patient may develop. Some of these can be sight-threatening. The general consensus about pathological myopia is the fact that it is any prescription that is more than -6 diopters or an axial length, i.e. the length of the eye, is more than 26.5 millimeters. The numbers with pathological myopia worldwide can vary depending on the literature that you read, but estimates have it between 2-3%. The significance of pathological myopia is the fact that it can lead to significant visual impairment, and estimates of this are up to about 1%, again differing depending on what literature you read. In terms of who develops pathological myopia, again, it's an interplay between genetics and the environment, and there is not one clear-cut answer. What we do know is that it tends to run in some families. Patients with pathological myopia will describe a gradual reduction in vision that occurs over time, and this will be reflected in a glasses prescription, which seemingly keeps on increasing. In terms of what may be seen then with pathological myopia, you can have certain conditions which would occur in other individuals otherwise, but these conditions can occur at a younger age. For example, cataracts can be seen in patients with pathological myopia at a much early age. Patients with pathological myopia are also at increased risk of having dislocated lenses within their eyes. Patients with pathological myopia also have an increased risk of developing glaucoma, and with respect to the optic nerve heads inside their eyes, these can be tilted and they can also have wear and tear changes around them, which is known as peripapillary atrophy. In terms of the changes that can be seen in the retina then, firstly and foremostly, patients may develop things such as lattice degeneration. Lattice degeneration is essentially where you get weakened areas within the retina out in the peripheries, and these areas and areas adjacent to them are at greater risk of developing tears and holes within the retina, which increase the risk of retinal detachments. The other thing that patients can develop is a staphyloma, which is outpouchings basically in an elongated eye, and this can be important when patients are having cataract surgery because they're at increased risk of having bleeding and perforations during the anesthetic procedure, as well as having generalized wear and tear changes in the back of the eye associated with pathological myopia. The two big risk factors for developing sight-threatening conditions are retinal detachments and choroidal neovascular membranes. This is a good point to clear up some confusion. What I mean by that is some patients who have injections into the back of their eyes, believing it to be for macular degeneration or wet macular degeneration specifically, they actually have myopic degeneration. So they have pathological myopia, and because of the elongated stretched eye, they develop abnormal blood vessels, hence the name choroidal neovascular membrane, and this can then bleed and cause similar effects to having wet macular degeneration. But technically speaking, it's not because of macular degeneration that they've had the bleed, it's due to their short-sightedness. So that's important to bear in mind. Patients with pathological myopia should be educated about their condition, attend their optometrist for regular checkups and an up-to-date refraction, and be aware of the red flag features to look out for, warning them of potential underlying issues such as flashing lights and floaters, which could indicate a retinal detachment, or sudden deterioration in vision, which could indicate a bleed especially if that is associated with distortion, i.e. straight things looking wavy. Patients should also be educated about the risk of them sustaining trauma because their eye is already elongated. They're more at risk of developing things such as retinal detachments. So, for example, some advocate telling these patients not to engage in activities such as bungee jumping, contact sports, etc. Thank you for watching this short video about pathological myopia. I hope I've taught you the difference between pathological myopia and normal short-sightedness, what some of the risks associated with pathological myopia are, and what patients should look out for, and important educational aspects that they should be informed about, and regular attendance to their optometrist is of utmost importance. If you've liked this video, then please do give it a thumbs up, click the like button, the subscribe button, and please do share my videos. Thank you so much. Until next time.